I'm Midori.
My name is Bailey.
Naomi.
Amaya Bowen.
My name is Ella.
My name is Amari Williams.
My hobbies are playing volleyball.
Probably volleyball.
And French horn.
I like to bake.
I play basketball and I do guitar.
I play volleyball. I've played for 4 years and I like art. What are my favorite features about myself?
I like everything about myself.
That's a hard one.
I'd say like my eyes, my eyelashes.
Three of my favorite features. Okay. I guess I like my height.
I think I'm outgoing and I make friends easily.
My smile. I wasn't really comfortable with wearing my hair out to school. And ninth grade was when I was just starting to become comfortable and learn how to properly do it. This was fairly recent. I'm a sophomore now, so it was like the beginning of freshman year. This person who I was friends with and very close with compared my hair to pubic hairs, which made me feel very uncomfortable and knocked down my self-confidence quite a bit. And I feel like that made my progress regress.
Microaggression is a form of casual racism. When a person of color might experience throughout their life.
Like something racist, but like low-key racist. When you get targeted in a classroom for being black and you're like, well, we're talking about racism and slavery today. How do you feel about it, Naomi?
I do know somebody who has had a microaggression towards them. It was mostly like about their hair, like they came in one day with their hair straightened and one of her friends kept feeling it. I was like, why does it feel like that? And like telling her how it doesn't look good. Black at a PWI was basically an account on Instagram that was created 2 years ago. And it's basically just students coming out about stories they've had with teachers who said a microaggression to them or a situation of like racist remarks.
It's from current students and alumni, and it just shows like that these things are still happening and that they're kind of swept under the rug when in reality it's like something that most black students face.
I think it's more talked about within black students at these schools, but not with like parents at all, because I think parents don't take into account what their children are going to be going through when they send them to these types of schools.
No, I don't really feel represented in my school. There being like around like 10 to 11 black kids in my grade already kind of just shows that there are just not that many of us.
I've only had like one black teacher a year.
I have one black teacher and it's for a class that I signed up for. It's like a black studies class. So yeah, I don't think the diversity among the faculty is very diverse.
This is a CBS News special report. I'm Chip Reed in Washington, where a curfew goes into effect at 11 p.m. Eastern Time. Protesters here in D.C. have gathered near the White House throughout the day, and we just learned President Trump was moved to the White House bunker on Friday night during protests out of an abundance of caution. This as demonstrations across the country grow after last week's death of George Floyd.
I believe that my school tried to make an inclusive environment for all students to share their opinions on the events that transpired.
Well, with this being a PWI, it didn't feel like the safest space for me to share how I felt. I had a family who I could talk to about it, so I kind of kept my opinions to myself in the school environment. Like throughout the years, like I've grown and I have more friends who I'm comfortable like sharing that feelings with, but like as at the time, it definitely felt like the conversation felt forced at school. So I kind of kept my opinions to myself and how I was feeling when they like brought it up in spaces.
We were all at home on Zoom, and like I felt like it was just like another loss hit for the Black community, especially since I live in a Black neighborhood. We all feel it there, and basically it's just a time I was like luckily able to spend with my parents, and then the outrage and like aftermath of the hell like situation, just getting like a simple email and not being able to really talk about it with anyone at school was pretty difficult.
I think that for me personally, it was nothing new. I was like desensitized to it, used to seeing Black men and Black women being killed on the news like 24/7 and constantly. A lot of teachers ignored it within classrooms. I do think that when conversations was held at school, it was from students and not teachers.
In middle school, I definitely felt like I didn't have any type of support group or safe space to go to. Last year, my friends and I created a Black student union, which is like the first Black student union our school has ever had.
The best song wasn't the single, but you weren't either. Living in Ladera Heights, the Black Beverly Hills, domesticated paradise. Palm trees and pools, the water's blue, swallow the pill, keeping it surreal, whatever you like.
Well, one thing about the Black community, I just love that even like in times of crisis or in times of just great joy, we can always like come together and like find each other and be able to like share our stories and our experiences and laugh and cry together. And even just like through social media or through schools, like you can definitely feel that connection between like the Black students and just the black community as a whole.
I really love the Black people's ability to create community in places where we're not welcome or where we don't feel welcome.
I just think that the beauty of the Black community is that we get to overcome, and we find these beautiful ways like through dance and music. And even though we're not like all just one like experience, we do find a lot of similarities and come together. Just like the richness and the fact that we're so unapologetically ourselves because of the amount of like shit we've had to deal with over and over and over. I think like that's just beautiful.
I would definitely say I've enjoyed my time, and I've definitely used up all of the resources here. There have been up and downs, but as a whole, I've definitely enjoyed my time.
Fuck. Look.
I'm in love.
If you like this video, make sure to hit like, comment, and subscribe to keep up to date with all of our RealWorks YouTube videos. And don't forget to watch the films of the next generation of filmmakers.